45 years after technician Fritz Veerman lost his job, was kidnapped and intimidated for speaking out about a nuclear scandal involving companies like Urenco, he's vowing to continue his fight for justice. The so-called whistleblowers being supported by a decision of the Dutch House of Whistleblowers. This new whistleblower authority says Veerman's treatment was wrong and his warnings about the Pakistani spy Abdul Khan were valid.
Het is heel belangrijk voor de samenleving.
It is very important for society to know what happened in the 1970s. The Dutch state has violated the Non-Proliferation Treaty. They have jeopardized the lives of millions because Pakistan sold the information to China, North Korea and Iran. This is huge.
In the early 1970s, Veerman worked together with Abdul Khan in a laboratory that designed a new technique to enrich uranium by using ultracentrifuges for Urenco. When Veerman visited Khan's house one day, he became suspicious.
In his room, I saw drawings of the ultracentrifuge, secret drawings. For sure, that's not allowed.
But when Veerman told his employer, Stork, he believed Khan was a spy, he was told to keep quiet. When he didn't, he was sacked and held in detention by Dutch justice officials. His name ended up on a Secret Service watch list, and Veerman says agents regularly intercepted him when he was traveling.
It's very strange. A spy travels from Pakistan to the Netherlands to steal nuclear secrets and order equipment. The spy is not punished, but the man who reports him, the whistleblower, that's not how a democracy works. I want to know who gave the order for this.
The MP has asked for an investigation by the institution that oversees Dutch secret services. Ruud Lubbers, the former Dutch prime minister who died, said that the CIA had asked the Netherlands to not arrest Khan so they could see what he was planning. In 1998, Khan became the so-called father of the nuclear bomb in Pakistan and continues to be treated as a hero in his homeland. Analysts doubt it will ever be known who was responsible or the truth revealed of what happened.
It is a very complicated case with intelligence service involved from different countries even, you know. So a lot of information is lacking, so I wouldn't say we need court cases, we need apologies to Mr. Veerman.
Services should be held accountable too.
Of course, I think intelligence services should be held accountable.
In a response to Al Jazeera's questions, the Dutch Interior Ministry said the role of the former government needs further investigation, but didn't provide details about when that will happen. 45 years later, the Dutch government and the companies involved have yet to explain why state secrets could be stolen so easily and why nobody has been held accountable for the major consequences this theft has had. In a statement, Urenco says that what happened to Veerman won't happen again and a whistleblower mechanism is now in place. But for Fritz Veerman, this is not enough. He wants compensation and those involved to face justice. Stef Vaassen, Al Jazeera, Almelo.